Hello guys, in this video, I'm going to show you how to make this in Blender. So let's jump right into it. Now, if you want to use the same 3D model, you can purchase it on cgtrader.com, link in the description. I have modeled, textured, and rigged this Gundam 3D model myself, and it's ready to go. But, if you want to search for free Gundam 3D model, you can get it for free on website like Sketchfab. For example, you can get this amazing Gundam 3D model, or maybe this one. And then, you can rig it yourself. You can learn to do so by watching tutorial from YouTube, like this great video, link in the description. The only difference with the Gundam 3D model is you first need to separate the mesh according to the part of the bone. For example, you want to parent to the head bone. Then, you need to separate the head mesh first. After that, you can select the rig, hit tab to go to the edit mode, select the head bone, hit tab again to back to the object mode. Now, select the head part, and while holding shift, select the rig, and press Ctrl P. Select parent to the bone. Now, as you can see, the head part is parented to the head bone. And after that, you need to do the same things to the other part. After you get the 3D model, let's import it in Blender by clicking File, Append, go to Collection folder, and choose Gundam Bake plus Rig. Now, you get the asset imported. Now we need to make the path for the Gundam by clicking Shift-A, Curve, and add a Bezier. You can edit it by pressing Tab, then move, rotate, or scale the vertices to shape the path. You can also add segment by pressing E to extrude the path. Now, this part definitely needs some try and error until you get the one that you like. So go ahead and try around. Here, I want the path to turn to the left in the middle. And there you go. After that, we need to make an empty so that we can animate the Gundam on the path by pressing Shift A, add an empty, plane axis. Move it to the center of the Gundam torso. Make sure you check the in front in the object property tab. Now, select the Gundam rig and while holding Shift, also select the empty and press Ctrl P. Set parent to object. Now, the Gundam is parented to the empty. I'm using empty so that we can set the position, rotation, and scale of the Gundam separately from the rig. Now, add a constraint to the empty and choose follow path constraint. Set the target to Bezier path and press Alt G to position it on the path. I actually want the Gundam to be on the opposite end of the path. So go to Edit, Preferences, enable Add Curve Add-on. Then select the curve, go to Edit Mode, select the vertices on the opposite end, go to Edit, and click Set First Point. Also, make sure you check the fixed position so it will only move on the path that we created. Now, we can animate the empty. Go to the first frame, hover to the offset factor, set it to 0, and press I to insert keyframe. Now, go to other frame in timeline, set the offset factor to 1, and then press I again. And I want to set the duration to the length of the animation. Now the Gundam is moving on the path, but as you can see here, there is some slowing down at the start and right at the end of the animation, where I want it to have constant speed. So go to the timeline, select both keyframe, press T, and choose linear. To track the movement of the Gundam, select the empty, align view, view lock to active. If you want to change it back, you can select view lock clear. Now, I want to animate the orientation of the empty. So in the start, I want it to kinda in diving position. Make sure to use local transformation so the axis of the MT doesn't change. Make sure you're in the first keyframe and press I to insert location rotation keyframe. And I want it to do barrel roll. So in this timeline, I rotate it on Z axis 360 degrees. And insert keyframe again. Maybe adjust the timing a little bit. Now, I want to adjust the orientation of the Gundam after doing barrel roll and try to stabilize its movement. After that, I'm trying to fine-tune it and match the orientation of the Gundam to the path. And here's what the empty animation looks like. Now we can go ahead and animate the pose by selecting the rig and press Ctrl Tab to go to the pose mode. I put some control bones on the second layer and the rest on the first layer. Here, I'm making the pose for the first frame. The rig is already in IK, so for legs and arms, you can set it from the IK bones. And then I'm going to select all the bones and press I to insert location rotation keyframe. And I want to bend the leg after doing barrel roll. Maybe make the head tilt up. Keep on adjusting the pose and the timing. You can also copy-paste the keyframe if you want it to have the same pose. This is the pose animation so far. Now, I want to add some subtle movement. For example, for the hand, I want to make it swing after doing the barrel roll, because I think that's how the hand would react. So go to the keyframe where the Gundam finished the barrel roll. Move forward a couple frames, copy and paste the hand keyframe, go to the previous frame and swing it forward. Now, as you can see, there is some nice swing to it. Let's do the same thing for the other hand and swing it backward. Because of the direction of the barrel roll. I think what's important is you need to kinda imagine how to anticipate, follow through, and react to the movement to make it smooth. Now, I'm doing the same thing to the right leg. Keep on fine-tune and adjusting the pose until it looks smooth. Let's move on to the camera animation. So first, select view, align view, view lock clear. Then you want to duplicate the path by pressing Shift D. And this is going to be the path for the camera. So select the camera, add follow path constraint, select the new path as the target, and then press Alt G to position it at the start of the path. Make sure again you check the fixed position. Now at the start, with offset factor at 0, insert keyframe, then at the end, set it to 1, and insert keyframe again. To make it in linear speed, just like the Gundam, select both keyframe and press T, choose linear. We can go ahead and adjust the framing of the camera by pressing 0 to go to the camera view. I want to split the tab so we can see the path and the camera view. You can adjust the position of the camera by adjusting the path. And you can adjust the framing by using RR to free rotate, or maybe rotate it on single axis. Definitely need some try and error. I keep adjusting the position and framing to track the Gundam movement. And right at the end, I want the camera to move away. After some adjustment, here what I come up with. Now, you can add camera shake by go to the graph editor and add noise modifier to the X or Y rotation. This trick I learned it from Ian Huber tutorial. Then you can bump up the scale and reduce the strength to make it more subtle. And that's for the camera animation. Yeah, all the animation is done. Now we need to add some lighting to the scene. I'm going to use HDR image for the lighting. So go to the world properties and change the color to environment texture. Here I'm using free Aerial HDRI from hdrmaps.com. And I'm going to delete the point light from the scene. You can preview the HDRI by checking the scene world menu. As you can see, the HDRI on the background. I'm using cycles to see how the HDRI affect on the lighting. And to be able to rotate the HDRI, make sure you go to Edit, Preference, and enable the Node Wrangler add-on. Go to the Shader Editor on this tab, choose the World tab, and select the Image Texture node, and press Ctrl T, which brings us Mapping and Texture Coordinate node. Then, you can rotate the HDRI, and also set the strength. And for me, I want to control the HDRI for the background and for the lighting separately. You can do this by adding Mix Shader. Then, duplicate this whole node. And plug it into the Mix Shader. For the factor, I'm going to use Light Path node. And plug the East Camera Ray to the factor input. So one HDRI will affect the lighting and the other one as the background. Then you can control it separately. Here I want to change the HDRI for the lighting. The reason I'm doing this is I want the lighting to have more contrast, so the 3D model look more divine with the light and shadow, because the HDRI I'm using for the background is too soft. All the animation and scene setup is done. Great job for sticking around until this part. Now, we need to set the render settings. So go to the render properties, make sure you're on cycles. I'm using GPU compute for the device. And for the sampling, I'm using 200 sample. Make sure you check the denoise menu. Then I'm going to add motion blur and play around with the shutter setting. Basically, the more time taken between shutter open and close, the more it gets blurry. Here is the example between different shutter setting. For the output, I'm going to use 1920 and 1080 with 24 FPS. I'm using PNG sequence as the output. Then you can choose the folder for the output file. I'm using only the RGB channel, and so I think that's about it. You can go ahead and click render animation. So that's wrap up this tutorial. I hope you guys like it. Make sure to hit like and subscribe if you find this video helpful, and see ya!